How you doing, guys? I wanted to talk to you about this Linux distribution that I'm really getting into. It's called Puppy Linux. And some of the advantages I really like, which is it's very small, 100 megabytes total, and it loads directly into RAM. So when you boot it up, you can actually remove the media, that whatever you're booting from, like if a CD-ROM or a USB flash disk. And since it all the files and whole distributions in RAM itself, it's even faster than an SSD drive, because obviously RAM's based on a faster type of RAM. Now, this would make it excellent for a rescue CD. For some reason your computer doesn't boot up, you can boot up to this Puppy Linux, and you can access the hard drive for virus removal. It could be data recovery, or even format or partition the hard drive. And in fact, one of the software that I demonstrated last week, Microscope version 16, the full version actually also has Puppy Linux on the diagnostic CD as well. And so they give you an option when they boot up into the diagnostic, you can boot up into Puppy Linux, just for the reasons I told you, for fixing a Windows PC. So now I'm going to take you to the desktop screencast so we can look more into this Puppy Linux. We just booted up into, it's not Puppy Linux, it's actually a version of Puppy Linux called MacPup. And it includes some more software. It's about 188 megabytes vice 100, and it uses the Enlightenment window manager, which is E17. Besides that, it's basically virtually the same. Now, when you boot up into it from a CD-ROM or even a USB flash disk, you're going to have this configuration come up. And that's what I love about this. You can configure it very quickly if you're using it on a friend's computer for whatever reason, or another computer. And so here you can set your screen where you want to. And I defaulted to 1920 by 1200. And you can change some very basic settings, time and what have you. We're going to click on that. It actually brings up some more where you can actually set it up, connect to your network. I'm actually using a virtual machine, so I don't really need to do that. And plus you can, let's go into either wired or wireless. And I'm not gonna go that far because I'm already connected to the internet. And actually click on that as well. And you can also set up a firewall. And this uses the command line version or terminal to get your firewall started on this. And also click on this to gain some more settings. Perhaps when you run it off your friend's computer, if your sound's not working correctly, you got set up also sound. You need to set up your graphic card a bit better. You got two selections right here. Set up the X video, upgrade X drivers, set up printing, which is the CUPS printing system. And so actually it's very great for like I said, you want to run this on somebody's computer. Like I said, you don't have to install it. You just run it direct into the memory, and you can remove the disk. Another thing you can do is you can also load this on a USB disk, which I'm going to show you now. You'd have to boot up using the CD-ROM. And here you go to Applications, Setup, and Puppy Universal Installer. Now, you might have to do the boot flash, install Puppy to USB boot flash first, and it makes the USB disk bootable. So we're just going to click on that. It has several selections. I'm actually going to select USB flash drive, but you can install it in numerous type of drives, from regular hard disks, IDE or SATA, zip drives, and so on. And we're going to, I don't think I have the USB flash drive connected. And yeah, it's not on there, but that's how you would access it. So very great small Linux distribution, whether Puppy Linux or MacPup, which is gives you a little bit more full-featured distribution for things like that. So go check it out.